I spent a lot of time talking about that question of how freedom exactly fits into the argument as I was, I suppose, revising the final draft of the book. And I realized that what I was really arguing was that the institutions that I'm describing were institutions that upheld in various ways freedom. It's often a mistake to declare human rights. It's often an illusion of our Western civilization that if you just list the rights that people have, magically they'll have them. What really creates freedom are secure institutional frameworks within which it can flourish. The economic freedom that is central to competition, the intellectual freedom that is central to successful scientific inquiry, and so forth. The freedom to dispose over our property that was so central to Locke's thinking. So I think really what civilization is about as a book is the mainsprings, the frameworks within which freedom can flourish. I don't have any desire to backdate human rights, democracy, feminism, gay rights, or any of the recent freedoms that we've discovered. They're all of very recent provenance, some as recent as the 1960s. And they can't therefore have any explanatory value if we're trying to explain the rise of the West. Even, dare I say it, freedom of speech was highly circumscribed in most Western societies until very recently. Just ask Oscar Wilde. Think of all the things that were still restricted, banned from publication in England. Think of Lawrence's Lady Chatterley's Lover. No, the freedom of expression, like so many of the freedoms we enjoy today, is the kind of luxury you can afford once you've got the real killer apps to work, once you've established the real foundations of freedom. And in that sense, this is a not entirely comfortable history. It's not entirely what liberals want to hear about the past. And that's one of the reasons I'm rather fond of the book. I hope it's in some measure upsetting to readers of a more liberal persuasion and encouraging to those of a more conservative persuasion. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much.